Hormone replacement therapy is one of the crucial parts of medical transition for transgender women. It aligns the body with the identified gender, rewires the brain, helps fight gender dysphoria, and reduces symptoms of depression and anxiety. It seems that HRT has only positive effects for trans people, but there is a big but: risks that come alongside with benefits. Hi, I'm Kira, a transgender woman and counselor specializing in transgender care. I hear two polar thoughts from people who are considering starting HRT. The first is that they want to begin hormone replacement therapy as soon as possible, and it will only change their lives for the better. The second is that HRT will cause significant, even guaranteed damage to their health. I can relate to both perspectives, but as with any discussion, it's important to find a meeting point grounded in objective truth. In our case, science. Today we'll focus on health risks that HRT carries for transgender women. Before we start, I want to mention that most of the risks mentioned in this video are related to oral form of HRT. The first thing I read while researching HRT before deciding to medically transition was about the risk of cancer. This topic appeared in many of the first articles I came across. It added anxiety to an already hard decision. But let's take a deeper look at how real that risk actually is. The largest study was done in Netherlands on over 2,200 trans women. It found only 15 cases of breast cancer, with an average time on HRT being 18 months. That means that there were 43 cases of breast cancer per 100,000 person years. This rate is over 40 times higher than in cisgender men, but 1.7 times lower than in cisgender women. Most tumors were estrogen or progesterone receptor positive. It means that HRT likely played a role in their development. The same study showed that the average age of breast cancer diagnosis in trans women was 52, which is lower than in cisgender women. The risk emerged after 10-15 years of taking hormone replacement therapy. Another large-scale study made by Oxford University with over 1 million women over 50 found that estrogen combined with progesterone almost doubled the risk of breast cancer compared to taking only estrogen. Assigned male at birth people have different anatomy than cisgender women. One important difference is the prostate, a gland in male reproductive system located below the bladder and in front of the rectum. It surrounds urethra, the tube that carries semen and urine out of the body. Prostate cancer is the second diagnosed cancer in men worldwide, occurring in 62 cases per 100,000 people. This number varies widely depending on age, country, and type of research, but it still remains a common concern. So, do trans women face the risk of prostate cancer? Yes, because prostate is usually not being removed during gender-affirming surgeries and remains in the body. However, those taking HRT have a significantly lower risk compared to cisgender men. The Dutch study among 2,200 trans women found only 6 cases of prostate cancer, which lowered the risk by 80%. A 2020 study in the US found 14 cases of prostate cancer per 10,000 people per year in trans women, compared to 33 cases per 10,000 in cisgender men. This reduced risk is likely because the main driver of the prostate cancer, testosterone, is being suppressed by estrogen and antiandrogens. Prostate volume also shrinks, resulting in lower activity. However, these changes come with a downside: a more complicated diagnosing and screening. HRT significantly lowers prostate-specific antigen levels. While they might be normal for cisgender men, for trans women they might be extremely high and can be a signal for an early-stage cancer. There's another issue. Digital rectal exams can become difficult or impossible after vaginoplasty due to anatomical changes. Before starting HRT, I had several health issues: excess weight, high blood pressure, and heart problems. I worried that HRT would worsen these conditions. Fortunately, after weight loss, changes in the diet, and relief from long-lasting depression, these problems are no longer active for me. Still, I'm aware of the potential risks that HRT carries. One of the serious ones is related to blood clots and heart health. Blood clots form in veins and travel to the lungs. Symptoms of clotting may include pain, swelling, or warmth in one leg, sudden shortness of breath or chest pain, especially while breathing, coughing up blood, fast heart rate, or dizziness. This is a life-threatening condition that requires immediate medical attention. Estrogen, the main component of HRT, stimulates the production of clotting proteins in the liver, while reducing anti-clotting proteins. The risk is highest when estrogen is taken orally or in pills, and is much lower when it's taken in the form of injections or transdermal, like patches or gels, which bypass the liver. The now discontinued ethinyl estradiol, used in older contraceptives, carried an especially high risk of blood clots. A study with over 2,800 trans women showed that clotting risk was 2-3 times higher than in cisgender men, especially during first 2 years of HRT. In general, the risk of blood clotting in trans women is comparable to that of postmenopausal cisgender women. Additional risk factors include smoking, obesity, sedentary lifestyle, age over 40, genetics, and family history of VTE. We can't talk about blood clots without addressing the cardiovascular system. Estrogen can increase triglycerides, which raises the risk of heart disease. A 2021 study found that trans women have double the risk of heart attacks compared to cisgender women. The risk is similar or slightly higher compared to cisgender men. Cardiovascular risk increases with age, particularly after 45, due to pre-existing conditions like high blood pressure, arterial plaque, insulin resistance, and diabetes. Estrogen can destabilize arterial plaque, potentially increasing the risk of heart attacks. One risk is tied to a specific medication such as spironolactone, a common antiandrogen. It blocks androgen receptors and lowers testosterone, but it comes with a risk of hyperkalemia, high potassium levels in the blood. Spironolactone is a potassium-sparing diuretic. It removes excess water and sodium, but retains potassium. While this can be helpful for people with high blood pressure, too much potassium can be dangerous. Symptoms of hyperkalemia may include muscle weakness, numbness and fatigue, nausea, and irregular heartbeat. Most cases are mild and asymptomatic, and can only be detected with regular blood monitoring. If potassium levels are high, this issue usually can be resolved with lowering the dosage, switching medication, or adjusting the diet. Another risk of HRT is the formation of gallstones, hardened deposits of bile and cholesterol that can block bile ducts, which causes nausea, pain, and inflammation. Symptoms include sudden pain in the right upper abdomen, nausea or vomiting after meals, bloating or discomfort, especially after eating, and fever. Estrogen increases cholesterol in bile, leading to bile stagnation and the risk of gallstones. Risk factors include high-fat food, obesity or rapid weight loss, family history of gallstones, and prolonged use of oral estrogen. The recent study with over 30,000 trans women found that the risk of gallstones is significantly higher in those who took estrogen, 4.7% over 10 years. Over time, the gallstone risk for trans women becomes similar to that of cisgender women and 2-3 times higher than in cisgender men. The last risk I'll mention today is elevated levels of prolactin. Prolactin is well known for its role in breast milk production, but it also plays a role in over 300 biological processes. Estrogen, when combined with certain antiandrogens like CPA or spironolactone, raises levels of prolactin in trans women. In rare cases, it may cause prolactinomas or prolactin-secreting tumors. Symptoms of prolactinomas may include headaches, breast milk production, and vision changes. A 2020 systematic review found that prolactin levels raised by over 100% with CPA and over 45% with spironolactone. According to Endocrine Society guidelines, around 20% of trans women have elevated prolactin levels. In most cases, that is not dangerous, but regular monitoring is advised. HRT has saved thousands of lives. It's an incredible tool created by science and medicine that helps trans people find inner peace and align their bodies with their identities. But like any tool, it requires instructions, precautions, and understanding of consequences. In case of HRT, the consequence of misuse or neglect can be harmful to your health. I can't stress enough how important it is to do regular blood tests, monitor your health, and stay under the care of a knowledgeable doctor. When done properly, the risks of HRT are no greater than those faced by cisgender women. Don't let fear, misinformation, or anxiety overwhelm you. Hormone replacement therapy carries some small risks, but also the greatest reward – the ability to live your truth. If you enjoyed watching this video and want to support my gender transition, please consider donating for my sex reassignment surgery. You will find the link in the description below. Thank you for being with me. Please subscribe, hit the like button, and see you soon in my next video. Bye.